Does it all, Mark, just simply come down to the fact, like, you know, Paul Tudor Jones and others have said, and maybe you believe this yourself, you have an engaged Fed, right? You have the insurance policy of the Fed going to be there. That's powerful. Explosive was one of the words that PTJ used. Is that fair assessment?
I think it is. I think what people have learned is don't bet against the Fed, right? And if you sort of look at if the Fed is going to keep on lowering rates, and if the Fed is going to be very active and they want growth to come back, that's your one saving grace. Look, at the end of the day, I do think when you've got the New York Fed saying growth is going to be 0.4, that's not good. I'm sorry. I just don't think that's good. So if you're not going to have growth and GDP is going to go lower, that's not good news for stocks. The Fed will temper that. But I think people are putting too much faith in that right now.
What about for what you do? You suggested you'd like growth to be higher than that as well for the strategies that you deploy.
I just need growth to be, I just don't need us in a recession. So if we're flat to up one, that's great for bonds. It's great for credit. It's not great for equities. So I think what you're going to find is next year is the year of credit, whereas I think this year has been the year of sort of on the equity side. Even though credit has done well, I think it's going to do a lot better next year.
Oh, interesting. Josh, what do you make of that?
I think the big story this year is that the technicals have led the fundamentals and the economic commentary, and it should be that way. People are changing their opinion based on price. There was a Bank of America portfolio manager survey last week in which they recorded the largest ever jump in respondents expecting an economic expansion, a 43% percentage point jump from the prior survey. Why does something like that happen? There's only one reason. It's not that all of a sudden the economy got good. It's that we had new record highs, not only in U.S. stocks, but all over the world, including some emerging markets. So when you've got that backdrop, that technical backdrop of prices rising week after week, people start to change their minds. So the lesson, Scott, is to pay attention to what people are actually doing in their buying and selling and pay less attention in people's opinions about the future because they will change based on what they see on their screen. Last thing I want to get into, buybacks are up 26% year to date through the end of last week. Last week witnessed the sixth highest level ever recorded of buyback activity, according to Bank of America Merrill Lynch on the quant side. And when you think about what that, and tech, by the way, fourth highest ever. So, yeah, there are probably people who are still very concerned about things like impeachment, the economy, et cetera. But the mass buying of shares has continued throughout the course of the year and is hitting higher highs as we get into year end because there are existing buyback plans where they haven't finished what they've been authorized to do. So if you know that that's the backdrop, then understand the sales you're making are being purchased by the treasuries at corporations.